Welcome all the students who are in this forum, who are seeking knowledge, the knowledge seekers. I also warmly welcome their parents, which are the most important people for us, because parents take decisions, a lot of decisions these days, don't they? But we would like definitely the children to take decisions more than the parents. And we like that, you know, that responsibility factor to come on your children. So children, while you're on to whatever is going to happen today, you please listen. It's going to be for you completely. And it's a wonderful session, unprecedented, I would say personally, unprecedented in the history of any presentations. So we're going to look forward to most of the parents being there, most of the children being there, and of course, educators are already there. So first and foremost, I begin with, what is education? We are in the with the profession of education, aren't we? Most of us are. Children, you are taking education and we are giving education. So what is education? All right. Somebody is possibly thinking of, so this is, screen has happened. So give me a minute, sir. I'm not yet introduced you. So what is education? Education is a very broad term, which includes literacy in it. You know what we have, what we generally think education is, we think literacy is education. Literacy is only reading, writing, knowing a few subjects here and there. But education is such a broad term, it's an umbrella organization, it's an umbrella structure, which encompasses life skills, which encompasses, you know, how to deal with people, which in emotions, you know, critical thinking, all the 21st century skills is broadly termed as education. So literacy is one small component of that education. So this wonderful person, there's a writer, one a very famous writer of the 21st century. His name is Alvin Toffler. And he said such beautiful words, which is applying right now in our scenario and elsewhere, is that the illiterate, the illiterate of the 21st century will be those who cannot read, write, and not those people who doesn't know math, doesn't know history, doesn't know science, doesn't know geography. They will not be called illiterates now. But the illiterates will be called those people who cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn. Alvin Toffler, may his tribe increase. So that was, Alvin Toffler for us. You cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn. And that's exactly what we have to do in our present times today. Learn from each other, learn from the society, learn from coronavirus, learn from every bit that comes our way into takeoff. It's my pleasure to introduce to you two wonderful human beings, two academicians, not only two, but there are plenty of them here, but the two that I'm going to present to you. It's my absolute pleasure to introduce to you Mr. Raman Naidu. He is an IITian, most of you are all aspiring IITians, and he is a person par excellence in the sense that he is a human, wonderful human being. He knows his job, he knows, you know, IITs, he knows the NETs, he knows all that because he himself has been a ranker in his days when he was a student. And then he knows how to take it forward, and he has been abroad, he has been in India, he's done wonderful jobs all across, which I'm sure Lalita ma'am will enlighten us. But apart from that, he's humble. And that's what he wants to give back to society, what he has acquired, what the society has given him. So my utmost pleasure to introduce to you the chairman of Rockwood International School, Mr. Raman Naidu. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
And we have, thank you, sir. Yes, sir. Mr. Raman Naidu there for you, sir. Would you like to say a little hello to everybody?
Good morning, everyone. Thank you very much for generous and kind words. I will be talking about NEET, how really we can help the students and parents to accomplish their dreams and their visions and missions for a period of a couple of minutes. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, we are very, very anxiously waiting for that, sir. And I would like to introduce to you one of the best persons I've ever seen in the technology scenario. I feel like a kindergarten child in front of him. He's also an IITian. He's a passionate, educator. His name is Mr. Subramaniam Ranganeni. He's also with us. He's going to do the maximum presentation today. He's an IITian. He's rankers in IITian, like Mr. Naidu. And he is so much passionate about technology and how he integrates so beautifully in you know the Rockwood International School is something which you all have to really learn from him. For myself, all I can say is if I see myself as an outsider, I found myself to be absolutely at a kindergarten level when it comes to technology. And you can learn from that. You have to reach to the postgraduate level when you are with him. So he is going to present to you how to reach to postgraduate level, not only in technology, but also in education. So over to you, Subramaniam, sir. I warmly welcome you to the Rockwood International School presentation today. A small hello from you, sir. And then it goes to Lalitha, ma'am.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for those kind words. I'm looking forward to, you know, interact with most of the students today. There were plenty of questions that were popping up, you know, during the interactions with the parents and students. So I'm looking forward to this session today, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Incidentally, Subramaniam sir, as we call him very fondly, most of you children must be knowing, he's called as Subi sir, very, very fondly by all of us. He is also the CEO of Rockwood International School. So thank you, sir. Thank you, Raman sir. Thank you, Subi sir. And now I'm handing it over to Lalitha ma'am for doing the rest of it. Lalitha ma'am, you know, is fantastic human being herself. She is the principal of the entire Rockwood, you know, the Rockwood School, and she is the brainchild, the bone behind the whole structure. Over to madam, and let's have a wonderful session. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Anjali ma'am. Thank you, and a good morning, and a warm welcome to all of you. What I'm going to do right now is, you know, what expertise do we have in Rockwoods to run IIT, JEE, and NEET coaching? Well, I should say this expertise and experience began way back in 2005 when the two gentlemen whom Anjali ma'am introduced to you were students. They had procured excellent rank in MCET. And in those days itself, they have decided that what we have got, we need to give back. We need to give back to the youth in our place, to the youngsters who are budding and who have to enter their careers. So they just started the MCET Coaching Center. So their tryst with education began only with MCET coaching. Okay. And they began and they started training the youngsters for MCET. So if you see that way, and then the journey continued, post which they opened schools, but their schools are also were also called ranker school because they wanted the students who pass out of these schools to become rankers in MCET, and post which, those days it was MCET, post which we have the IIT, JEE and NEET, which have come about quite recently. Okay, so if you see the number of people who have, you know, passed through these coaching centers started by Naidu sir and Subi sir, you will find that there are thousands of them. But the best testimony I see in front of my eyes are in Mr. Naidu's family himself. Okay, he has his brother and his three nieces who are doctors. Okay, and all of them, there was one child, one doctor who graduated very recently too. Just I think a couple of months back, and we held a very nice private convocation for that child. So she was talking, while she was saying, she was talking about how she was coached. She studied in Rankers, how she was coached to come out with flying colors. And incidentally, she is not done in any of the paid colleges. She is from Gandhi Medical College, which itself stands a testimony that she has come or she has got a free seat in the medical entrance test. Okay, so it is a wonderful thing, dear children. Why I'm telling you this is the unfortunately neither Naidu sir nor Subhi sir have, you know, kept a track of the alumni of Rankers Akruti and the coaching which they have done. But I have come across in my stint with them several students who have passed through their expertise and are in important positions today in various fields, whether in medical field or in the field of engineering and other corporate world. So I just wanted to tell you this before I hand it over to Subramaniam sir for taking over. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Let me just bring out my presentation over here.
Half a second, sir. While sir is putting his presentation, I request all the participants here, if you have any contacts, to go and inform them immediately, because this is going to be one of a kind of presentation which is not really anywhere put up so far. So if you have friends, family, or anybody extended, please call them immediately and say it's starting. Let them join in. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Anjali ma'am and Lalita ma'am, for those kind words and talking about how we have started our organization. Today, very quickly, we wanted to talk about a 360 degree approach to IIT, JEE and NEET competitive exams. Quick agenda. We have heard an overview from Anjali ma'am, and then I would be talking about JEE exams and, you know, what kind of parts, you know, what kind of levels that exam has, and then, you know, the pattern, and then the marking scheme, and, you know, all that. And then I also will be talking about different IIT colleges that we have and what is the cutoff ranking for each of the college. Similarly with NIT colleges and number of seats and then cutoff ranking for each of the college, right? And then Naidu sir would be talking about in detail about NEET competitive exam. And then we will be talking a lot today about Rockwood's IIT JEE and NEET curriculum and pedagogy. And then that would be covered by all the leaders that we have over here. And finally, Lalita ma'am would be closing the session. So this is what the agenda is going to be for today's session. The few slides in the beginning, I would be running through very, very quickly. So I want all of you to be very attentive and, you know, listen to it. And if you have any questions, please go ahead and post those questions in the chat window as well. So what is JEE? I think some of you may be already aware, and last 1.5 months, I would have met around 400 odd kids, you know, and their parents also. There have been plenty of questions, especially about, you know, IIT, JEE and NEET. What kind of exams are going to be conducted? What is the pattern? When is it going to be conducted? How can I prepare? How will the organization, the school is going to help me? And where do I get, you know, those kind of plenty of questions are, were coming up to us. So that was the reason why we wanted to, you know, hold this kind of webinar and answer most of your questions, what we were getting, right? JEE stands for Joint Entrance Exam. And this examination basically will be conducted by a national testing agency to basically to take the admissions into the premier engineering colleges that we have in India, right? Basically IITs, NITs and IIITs and CFTIs, like centrally funded technical institutes in India, right? This exam is divided into two levels. right? Level 1 exam is called JEE Mains, and level 2 examination is called JEE Advanced. And qualifying criteria is very, very simple. The children who have opted mathematics, physics, and chemistry in senior secondary are eligible to take this exam. And these children should have passed senior secondary, either with CBSE board or ICSE board or even Cambridge, IB, DP, and you know, IP, right? And minimum score that they should have got is 75%, but there are some category of students who can would have scored even between 65 to 75% are allowed to take this exam. Okay, I think one of the child is talking about my voice is low. I hope my voice is clear now. I'm moving a little closer to my computer. And this exam is basically conducted by National Testing Agency. And, you know, they take experts from CBSE and, you know, they prepare the exam paper and all that. And this JEE Mains is based computer-based testing. So meaning children have to go to, you know, some testing centers, and that's where they need to take exam in front of the computer, where it is thoroughly, you know, technology is developed and, you know, all that. And in case of JEE Mains, as far as the pattern, question paper pattern is concerned, and year to year, there may be little changes, but as far as this year is concerned, JEE Mains had 20 multiple choice questions, right? And then 10 numerical questions for each mathematics, physics, and chemistry, meaning you will have 90 questions, right? So 60 questions are MCQs, 20 each, maths, physics, and chemistry, and then 10 numericals, again in mathematics, 10, physics 10, and chemistry 10. But out of these 10 numericals for each of the subject, you have to answer only 5. You don't need to answer all 10. Okay, I request children not to annotate. Let me also disable it. All right. Now you can take a chance of annotating. I have disabled it for everyone. Right? This choice is given only this year because there was a pandemic, and there is a reduction in the syllabus in terms of plus one and plus two. And but whereas for JEE syllabus is not slashed, so because of that reason they have given this choice, but prior year there was no choice. So all 20 multiple choice questions and 10 numericals each child has to answer in the exam. And then as far as the marking scheme is concerned, MCQs basically are the single correct answers only, right? And every correct answer will be awarded 4 marks. And then if the attempted answer is wrong, you will be given negative marking. So minus 1 mark basically. And if you don't attempt, you will be awarded 0 marks for that. And as far as the numericals are concerned, the every correct answer, you are going to be awarded 4 marks. And there is no negative marks for numericals, right? That is about JEE Mains, but few other details of JEE Mains, right? This year, JEE Mains is conducted 4 times. 4 times. Children, you will have an opportunity to write JEE Mains multiple times, right? This year, it is conducted 4 times. Otherwise, usually it is conducted twice in a year, right? And if you're writing multiple times, the best score will be taken into consideration while taking admission into the colleges. So suppose you have written first time, you scored 97%, and second time you scored 99%. So second time score will be taken into account. And most of the children were also asking about how is this score is calculated, JEE mains, it is known as NTA score, right? So it is calculated as 100 into number of children who scored less than or equal to your score, divided by total number of children who have taken exam in that session. So just keep a note of this, but if you are not understanding this formula, you don't worry about it. And you know, we will be holding further sessions where you will be able to understand in detail how this score is calculated, right? And based on NTA score, which is JEE main score, right, this score itself is sufficient to take admission into NIT and IIITs and CFTI colleges. You don't need to take JEE advanced at all, right? I repeat, NTA score itself is sufficient to take admission into NITs, IIITs, and CFTIs colleges. You don't have to take JEE advanced exam, right? And NTA score also will be used to basically as a qualifying criteria to enter into the advanced examination, which is second level exam in JEE, which is known as JEE advanced examination. So let me talk about that exam in detail. Second level of exam, JEE advanced, it is conducted by one of the IITs, right? First level exam is conducted by NTA, National Testing Agency, and second level exam is going to be conducted by one of the IITs. So they will take turns. Every year one IIT will be conducting this exam. Second level exam, JEE advanced, is also computer based testing. It is not going to be pen and paper test. And advanced exam will have two papers, paper one and paper two. Both you will be writing on one day. Both you will be writing on one day. Paper one is going to be 3 hours. And again, the pattern typically changes little year on year. But more likely, you know, the kind of questions that typically come, I am covering it over here. Please take a look at it, right? Paper one, as per this, like, you know, last year pattern, 2020. So you had, you know, single correct options, 6 questions basically, and 3 marks are given for every correct answer and -1 for every wrong answer. That is section one. And section two, you have 6 questions and these are multi-correct options, meaning there can be more than one answer will be correct in MCQ, right? And 4 marks will be given for correct answer, and there is a negative marking also, right? And there is also partial marking, right? If there are 4 correct options and if you're answering only 2 of them, there is a partial marking also. Negative marking is -2 for this. If answer is not correct, you are going to get -2, right? And numerical value also, answer is also going to be like, you will have 6 and 4 marks for every correct answer, and there is no negative marking for this, correct? These 3 sections are going to be there again for math subject, for physics subject, and also chemistry subject, right? And paper two, this you will write in the afternoon on the same day with a couple of hours break in between. The paper two pattern typically is going to be multi-correct options. You will have 6 questions and then 4 marks for correct answer, and then negative marking will be there. And numerical value answer, again, you will have 6 questions, 4 marks for every correct answers with no negative marking. And there is also single digit answer where, again, 6 questions and 3 marks for every correct answer with negative marking also is there, right? Again, children, year to year pattern, typically there will be a little change, but more or less this kind of questions are typically covered. There is one other type of questions which were there before, comprehension based question, right? Where there is a paragraph and based on that, some questions will be asked even in maths, physics, and chemistry, right? And JEE advanced score will be used to allot JEE ranking, All India ranking. Based on JEE ranking, All India, seats are allotted across all the IITs in our country. So to enter into IITs, you should be mandatorily writing second level of exam based on the qualifying score of JEE mains. So in order to get into IITs, you need to be clearing JEE mains, and then you should be securing JEE advanced good rank. Then you will be able to enter into IITs. But if you want to get into NITs, IIITs, CFTIs, then JEE main score itself is sufficient. And these are, you know, some of the cutoff scores as per 2020, like, you know, what score was eligible to write the JEE advanced exam, right? Common ranking list, basically 90% above score, only those children were allowed to write JEE advanced exam. And there are some category of students with, you know, some reservation, even with little less percentage, they were allowed to take the exam. And this cutoff, as per the trend, every year the cutoff mark was increasing, right? Because there is a severe competition, and, you know, children were preparing well, and, you know, all that. And typically this score was every year is increasing. So year to year, this selection criteria cutoff ranking changes. This was the last year's one. And see, these are the IIT colleges, and as of right now, we have 23 IIT colleges, right? And I also have given little ranking based on Ministry of HR, you know, they have given ranking. And if you look at first top six are, you know, eight ranks, there is not much difference among them. Some they call IIT Madras as a top ranking college, and some call IIT Kharagpur as a, you know, top ranking college. Some call IIT Mumbai and then IIT Delhi. There is not much variance to me, basically, right? They are, you know, top notch colleges, and, you know, the best not only in India, even across the world, right? These are the rankings, and also in each of the college, the number of seats that I have kept over here, right? And in all, we have as of, you know, 2020, right? This number typically goes up because the new IIT colleges, every year they add little seats, new branches they add, new streams that they add, and all that, right? As of right now, 9,834 IIT seats you have. This number will go up by the time you will be writing the IIT JEE exam in next 2 years. And, you know, for IIT Madras cutoff ranking, right? So computer science and then electrical engineering, and then, you know, you also have ECE, which I have not captured over here. So if you see computer science engineering, like, you know, closing rank was 158. So that's it. That was the last rank by which you can, you know, get the, you know, seat in IIT Madras. This is again 2020. Right, year to year it typically changes, and then, you know, it only becomes little better in the ranking and all that, right? So, and computer science and electrical and electronics, those three are, you know, and even IT, those are popular branches, you know, which most of the students opt, and, you know, the best rankers typically opt those ranks if you look at it, right? This is cutoff ranking for IIT Madras for, you know, the year 2020. Similarly, for NITs, right, you have around 31 NITs, you know, from looking at this list. And there is also ranking, you know, across India, you know, basically South NITs are popularly known and equivalent of IITs, right? And you can look at the number of seats as well, and the number of programs that they are conducting. Basically, these are the branches that, you know, they are offering in those, you know, NITs, right? These are, again, you know, top-notch colleges, you know, in India, not only in India, and some of them are pretty good, as equal as, you know, IITs, right? If you look at the ranks also, it is very, very clearly evident, right? And total number of seats that you have, NITC is 17,523. Again, this number will definitely go up by the time you take this exam, because there are some of the colleges which are very recently set up, and year on year, they double their numbers typically, right? And again, for one of the NIT college, I have taken only one sample for IIT, one sample for NIT. But you know, we have all the details. You can definitely contact. So for NIT Tiruchi, what is the cutoff ranking for 2020? This is what it is, right? If you look at computer science, ECE, and then electrical and electronics engineering, so top rankers have got into this. And the other branches also are there. Okay, that is about in detail. About JEE, and then the different levels and the pattern, and also the cutoff rankings, and all that. And I will be talking, how you can track. This exam with little planning and all that as part of the Rockwood's IIT JEE curriculum more in detail along with NIDU sir. So right now, if you have any questions, please take the opportunity of raising hand about IIT JEE, or you can send the question in the chat window as well, so that I'll be more than happy to clarify your question or doubt. Yeah, Sahasra, please go ahead with your question.
Sir, good morning, sir. You have said two times in a year. Can we do the same for advanced, or only once in a year?
No, as of right now, it's only once in a year. The mains is conducted four times, but advanced exam is only once as of right now. In future, we may be able to have opportunities, even here you might have, but it is not anything.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Subhi, I think children to enter the chat message.
I hope, okay, the children can chat actually.
Somehow, I am unable to send chat SMS.
I can. I got your message actually.
To you, not to everyone.
Yeah, just select in the drop down as to everyone, and then you will be able to select.
Oh.
Yeah.
Option is not available somehow. Okay. Anyway, if children can able to, that's fine. I am unable to select even for everyone.
You can send it to me. I mean, I will be. I can coordinate that session. As I mentioned, there are little technical challenges for today's session. So
yep.
I think that would be all. I think I now request you to quickly talk about NEET, and then we'll go from there.
Okay. Please share the PPT.
Yes.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you, Subhi, for sharing the PPT and giving me an opportunity to talk about NEET. Children, during the days of learning, because whatever we have been learning today, this learning should take us for another 60 to 70 years of our life, and it should give bread and butter to ourselves and our next generation, and also our parents who have been taking care of us for the past few decades. So learning cannot be for one exam or 1 year. Learning is for lifelong. With this note, I would like to talk about NEET, which is the most important exam all of us should really understand if one wanted to become a doctor in their life. Couple of years back, our Supreme Court had given a guidelines to central government how to bring everyone across India, Kashmir student to Kanyakumari student, Assam student to Gujarat student, Telangana student to Maharashtra student, and one single platform, try to evaluate, validate their skills, and so that everyone will become part of one testing exam, so that children capabilities and also bring uniformity across the examination patterns, and children will not be required to write multiple exams to get seat into medical streams. Prior to this decision, there were many exams were conducted by many other institutions. Some of the exams are something like JIPMER exam, AIIMS exam, NEET exams, and state board competition exams, Karnataka set exam, Tamil Nadu set exam, Telangana set exam, something like this. When we were having so many exams, children were really confused themselves and are unable to focus on one or two exams and try to channelize entire their energy towards performing the best in exam, rather than they were spending time in traveling to write the exam or applying for a particular exam or just trying to understand the syllabus of those exams. So where lots of confusion, lots of administrative works were there for the children. With the decision of bringing one exam across the states, across the boards, it helped the students to focus only one target, that is preparing very well for NEET exam, do well, try to achieve the best, whatever you can do in your capabilities. So NEET is the one which is the exam conducted by National Testing Agency. The same exam also conducted by same agency also will conduct IIT mains. It's a nationwide common entrance test for admission into undergraduate medical colleges, both private and government, and aided and non-aided. There is a separate exam for AIIMS and JIPMER, that only these two institutions are conducting separate exams. Other than these, all the institutions, all the medical colleges all over the world take NEET score as a baseline for their admission process. Karen Sibi. The eligibility criteria, again, something similar to IIT mains. Children had to pass their grade 12 or senior secondary equivalent exam in three subjects, biology, physics, and chemistry. If it is some of the state boards, it is botany, zoology, physics, and chemistry. With 50% for unreserved category, and minimum age limit is 17 years of. Unlike IIT mains, IIT advanced, NEET exam is pen and paper test. It's objective test papers. It has three subjects, namely biology, physics, and chemistry. Biology is having around weightage of 50%. That means out of 720 marks, 360 marks are for biology, and 180 marks are for physics, and 180 marks for chemistry. How the marks are divided into different questions are, biology will be having around 90 questions. Each correct answer will carry 4 marks. Each wrong answer will cut 1 negative mark. Similarly, for physics, there will be 45 questions. For each correct answer, they will award 4 marks. Each negative answer, wrong answer, they'll cut 1 negative mark. Similarly, for chemistry, 45 questions will be there. 45 into 4, it is 180 marks for all the correct answers. If there is any negative or wrong answer, they'll cut 1 mark. So totally, if you look at NEET exam, there will be 180 questions from all the three subjects. Out of these 180 questions, if you write every question right, you'll be scoring around 720. If there are any mistakes, there is a possibility of having negative scoring. Hence, you reduce instead of one positive question, if you write one negative. So total loss for you is around 5. For example, if you write a correct answer, you'll get 4. The same question, if it's wrong, you'll get -1. So there is a net loss to the student is around 1. Whereas if really clear and correct for a particular question, so you'll be awarded with 4 marks. Otherwise, you can leave the particular question, you will not have any negative marking for a particular question. So as discussed, this total 720 marks and each 4 marks and one for negative for incorrect question, and total duration of the entire exam is 3 hours, that is 180 minutes. NEET examination is conducted by National Testing Agency, which works very closely with CBSE. So that is the reason now across the states of India, most of the students who are really preparing for NEET exams and IIT JEE exams trying to take or opt for CBSE syllabus, because the entire examination is conducted by the NTA, which is one of the subsidiary of CBSE board. Hence, I always recommend every parent to align their children's preparation towards CBSE syllabus, that is NCERT books. Hence, CBSE is the one which is the most important body which is going to help the students to conduct this exam and also make sure that children perform best. So hence their curriculum, syllabus, and also assessment will be in line. The NCERT textbooks are taken to be the Bible for the NEET exam. Out of these 180 to 600 questions will be directly from NCERT textbooks, though there are other 20 to 30% questions will be application questions, but still underlying topics will be from NCERT textbook. So the baseline book, the Bible for entire NEET examination, is NCERT textbook. The syllabus is in line with these textbooks. Yes, sir. The minimum eligibility criteria qualifying score in NEET is for unreserved category, it is 50th percentile, and scheduled category 40th percentile. Admission into government medical colleges restricted to high scores, and the usual cutoff is between 500 to 510 marks. If some student scores above 600, he will get seats in best of medical colleges, something like Gandhi Medical College, Usmani Medical College, if it is in Telangana. If it is in Andhra, they may get seat in Andhra Medical College and any other government medical college, something like Guntur Medical College. So if you wanted to get the seat in the best medical colleges across the state, you have to perform the best and score at least above 510. And then any advantage over above this 510, you should be able to get seat into best medical college like Gandhi, Usmania, or Kakatiya Medical College. Next, we'll go to other private medical colleges, though there is a chance of getting a seat, free seat. So there are other seats available. That seats also need to be selected from NEET rank, whether it's self-finance course or sponsored categories also had to selected through NEET score. So there are total 25,000 MBBS seats available in government medical colleges throughout the country, and 27,000 seats available in private medical colleges around the country. That means per year, there are only 52,000 medical seats are available all over India for 130 crores of people. Every year, we are seeing only 52,000 students are entering into medical stream. There is a huge demand for this profession. You have seen how the world is running towards the medical hospitals or medical healthcare services. I always encourage the students and parents, encourage your children to pursue this course. There is a great respect and demand towards this profession, and we can really help and serve humanity, people with service nature, and be able to help humankind. Approximately 15 lakh students take the NEET exam each year. Nearly 7 lakh of students are qualifying mark. So competition ratio is 1. 15 lakhs divided is for 52,000 seats, it's 60. So you need to meet with 60 students for scoring and getting a seat. So most important thing is encourage the students to thoroughly plan for 2 years intensively so that you will get clear over other repeaters so that they will be having little gap compared to your own class students. So be next one. Students, I would like to talk about what are the most important topics students really focus upon to score best in NEET. So though many students have understanding that we will get advantage of not solving problems when you choose by PC, but it's not true. 99% of physics and chemistry problems will be there. If you take 45 questions in physics and 45 questions in chemistry, at least 30 to 35 questions in chemistry will be all the problems or numericals will be there. When it comes to physics, 40 to 43 questions will be physics. So the biggest advantage will be for the students who can really solve physics and chemistry problems very well. Hence, I always encourage the students, especially in the vacations times or in leisure time, start practicing problems in physics and chemistry. Because when it comes to biology, since most of the students have inclination towards the botany and zoology subject, the trend in these exams is the most of the students will score best in botany and zoology. Out of 360, there is a possibility that every student out of 15 lakh students scoring above 300 who is probable candidate for NEET rank. So advantage will be for the students who will take edge in physics and chemistry. So hence, what I recommend is students who wanted to do best in NEET exam need thoroughly prepare very well for biological science topics, that is genetics, ecology, cell biology, morphology, biotechnology, reproduction, physiology of plants, animals, so that you will score above 300 in biology. So 90% you are scoring in biology. And remaining time, you need to extensively prepare very well for physics. Physics, the most important are optics, mechanics, nuclear physics, and thermodynamics. All these topics are very much important. These topics were there in your grade 9 and grade 10. They were introduced in grade 2 classes. But somehow we have been reading theory of these topics. Now we need to understand how to solve problems based on the applications of these topics. Fortunately, part of the curriculum, NCERT book or the textbooks are built on this NCERT textbook. There will be plenty of for each concept. As a student, we thoroughly need to understand first the concept, try to understand the derivation of the formulae, and try to utilize this derivation formulae to solve the entire problem so that we don't need to by heart or remember or memorize the formula, try to apply in the exam. This will not work out. If you wanted to get complete understanding of a particular concept, particular formula, you need to understand derivation of it. Try to use the derivation process to solve the problem, at least initial 4 to 5 problem. Then automatically you should be able to solve the problems using your formula. I was having discussions with my students when in the morning routine, when I was spending time in the morning times, many students were complaining that, sir, I'm unable to use the formula in the exams. I am sure many of you have seen this problem in your day-to-day life when you wanted to write exam just by bahating formula and substitute the values in the exam. This will not help you. You need to try to understand derivation, substitute the values so that you master the concept. Mastering the concept is more important. Repeatedly practicing same kind of concept for different kinds of values, different kinds of tweaking the questions is more important. Otherwise, this is not a regular routine intermediate board exam to test your basic skills and allow you to pass. This is a competitive exam. This test is wanted to test between the best of best students and find the students' ability to solve the problems. When the government is screening the students for eligibility test into medical streams, that means they are trying to give you the opportunity to work with the bodies of humans, right? The lives of humans, you should be really good enough to solve the problems with your thinking, your analytical abilities, and your problem solving abilities. So exam cannot be for the people who just memorize for 20 hours and write go on exam. No, this exam will test your abilities of analytical skills, problem solving skills, your emotional skills, and also will test your complete grassroots understanding of each topic. Hence, children, if you wanted to score best in NEET, you need to be thoroughly good at physics and chemistry. If someone is having idea that since I am poor at mathematics, I can perform best in botany, zoology, and still get NEET rank, it's really difficult and really impossible. I always recommend you need to get hang of solving mathematical problems of physics and chemistry. Mathematical solutions of physics and chemistry. So then you will get edge over these things. As I discussed, 300 plus, very easy to score in botany, zoology. Chemistry, 140 plus, easy to score in chemistry. Physics, 100 plus, very easy to score. If you can score 300 plus 140 plus 100, I am sure you will get seat into best of best medical college. This you can achieve it with concrete plan for next 2 years, intensive focus towards your academics, and also focus on your own body and mind and your own diet and your own activities. When you structure your day morning 5 o'clock to night 9:30 with complete focus on your own acts and deeds. Some of the students have too many aspirations, too many inspirations, but their day will not be structured. When you don't really start your day with focus on your physical exercises and focus on your mind, what will happen is you will not be able to spend focus 30 to 40 minutes of time on one topic. You should not be able to tackle the problems because this requires repeated practice of different kinds of problems with different tweaking of questions that will give you sound understanding of the concepts. Hence, you should be able to thoroughly perform. I will promise you, whoever is going to join at Rockwoods, we will work, entire team of Rockwoods will work very closely with your students, make sure that they will prepare thoroughly well from morning 5 o'clock to night 9:30 if there are hostlers. If there are day scholars, morning 8 to evening 5 o'clock, we'll schedule your day so that you will be able to get complete understanding of NCERT topics and also solve the problems with clear conceptual understanding and solving the problems with complete derivation of formulae. Hence, that is a rock solid foundation for you. I'll assure you that the basic concepts of the students will be best. Once you are really good at these concepts by covering NCERT syllabus, you should be able to perform best in your NEET examinations. Thank you very much. I'll be here for a couple of minutes. If anyone having any questions on the preparation, as Lalitha ma'am said, my own family, I made my brother and my nephew and my nieces to become doctors because my family is from agriculture family. My father was having a passion that I wanted to make one student, one child as a engineer, remaining as doctors. I am really proud to say that I spent very closely good amount of time with my own brother and my own nephews and nieces. I made them to be work hard for a couple of years. Then they are all successfully completed their graduation at MBBS at different colleges. Now they are serving the society as doctors. Thank you very much. Thanks for giving me this opportunity.
So I think Lalitha ma'am, before I can hand over, I'll just take a quick 1 minute to add a few more points. See, in terms of why reports for IIT, JEE, and then NEET kind of competitive exams, right? See, we are going to give very intensive, personalized, focus approach for every student, right? The management over here is not into the administration alone, right? We are into academics, we teach, right? And then smart work over hard work is very, very important, right? NCERT syllabus is very, very important, and we have mastered it, and we have excellent staff experience who can cover that. And I think Madhu sir covered a few of the important topics. Because of lack of time, I could not cover for maths and physics, but there are some important chapters if you can focus, if I take physics, mechanics, and then the electricity in plus two, are the, have maximum weightage, even if I take, mathematics, a chapter something like circles, has, probability, have very, very good, weightage, all that. And then the kind of culture which Naidu sir talked about, in terms of rather than memorizing, using derivation and then rigorous practice and, same questions they will ask, tweak it differently, right? And then with the rigorous practice and, repeatedly making them to do it, speed and accuracy will be definitely improved, right? Even for NEET, there is a good rumor that it is going to become a computer-based test, right? And meaning the kind of practice that happens in the exam, similar kind of thing should happen from the day one, right? Our school is very well equipped in terms of the infrastructure that we have, right? And not only that, the assessments planned for senior secondary in terms of weekly, monthly, and then kind of assessments, and it will be conducted in pattern of IIT, JEE, and NEET on the computer itself, so that similar style, similar scenario we can recreate, right? This is about very quickly about from us and all that. And if there are any questions, please go ahead and raise your hand. If not, okay, there is a question about, is there a age limit in terms of JEE? Typically, yes. But it's not that hard age limit the way how we have for medical field. Even for engineering field, there is an age limit, but typically it is not very, closely looked at it and all that, you don't have to worry about, right? But medical field, they're very, very particular with that. And engineering, as long as you qualify the exams and then, clear plus two, you are good to go. So you don't have to really worry about age in terms of engineering, right? Okay, let me unmute Lalitha ma'am so that she can conclude the session. We are little over time. Lalitha ma'am, please take it over.
Thank you. Thank you, Subhi sir. Thank you, Naidu sir, Subhi sir, Anjali ma'am, for the wonderful session you have taken. I was just listening to the entire, the the entire, I think you people have, you know, literally sieved every part of JE NEET exams. Thanks a lot. And I think, children, you have got a lot from today's session. And as Anjali ma'am said in the beginning of her session, a quote by Alvin Toffler, "The illiterate of 21st century are none but those who cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn." And the same person wrote a book called Education in the Future Tense. And you will not believe he has so many years back said that education is all about learning to learn, learning to relate what you learn, and learning to apply what you learn. So, children, it's very futuristic what he gave, but today it is so real and so very true to the education system we are all moving towards. So, children, I wish you all the best, and I hope and wish that all of you should forge ahead in your careers with a wonderful focus, and wish you all the best from all of us at Rockwoods International. Thank you very much.
Thank you all. We conclude the session for now. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Thank you. So can I add just one small thing?
Sure,
to all the children who are in this platform, to all the students who are here, to their parents, is that at Rockwood International School, grade 11s have already started, and it's a blended system where even your coaching, integrated coaching into fulfilling your dreams of being either an IITian or a medical professional is already getting it started on. So for those parents and children who don't know about it, may I tell you that it has started a couple of days back and it's going on in full spring. Would you like to also join in? You are most welcome. And if you have any suggestions to your friends and all, after listening to the session, that you are in safe hands and in the hands of experts out here, this is the best avenue for you to get on it, particularly because it's a CBSE-based system and it's very close to getting on to IIT and medical. So with this, we wish you all the best, and make sure that don't lose even a single day of opportunity, because opportunity knocks only one time. It doesn't knock every now and then. So this is an opportunity that has come your way. Grab it, take it, and fulfill your dreams and chase your dreams. Thank you so much. God bless all. Be safe. Take care of yourselves. Have a wonderful day. Thank you, sirs. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am, for being here.
Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.